During the monitoring of development response to displacement impact projects funded projects, including health facilities in Kiriandongo, the Deputy IGG, Dr. Patricia Achan, made an impromptu visit to Masindi Port Health Center 3, where she discovered that out of the 12 staff recruited, only 3 were present, while the rest, including the health in charge, Dennis Okello, had absconded from duty without notification.
Whoever goes on training has to put it in writing and get clearance from the accounting officer, not just get up and go away for training and leave the health center unattended too, because that leaves the people out there suffering without service delivery.
Dr. Patricia Achan also visited Kaduku Health Center 3, and here she only found 2 staff present, including an enrolled nurse and an askari.
Because when you absent yourself from duty, it has got serious implications on the people who expect to receive services from you. So we are passing a strong warning to all civil servants out there that we are not going to take these issues lightly, because you are letting this government down when you do not measure up to your expectations.
She ordered Martins Jakan Gokto, the Kiriandongo Chief Administrative Officer, to immediately take serious disciplinary action against the staff and sent her a report.
In case all the 25 have come at a go, then the person who is at the health center cannot attend to all. So those people who go for training at least need to put it in writing. And where they have not, disciplinary action should be taken, because there is no training that is you just jump and go for without following procedures.
We have daily attendance, whatever, we take records, and anybody found not to meet the required whatever attendance rate will be punished.
However, the Kiriandongo Chief Administrative Officer says they still have inadequate health facilities in the district.
Our health facilities are now doing well. We have good facilities, though not adequately to the expectation, but in a good percentage, in good proportion, they're in good state with this funding support.
Edith Aliguma, the Kiriandongo LC5 chairperson, and Dan Muganga, the Kiriandongo Resident District Commissioner, say the district has benefited a lot under the development response to displacement impact project, especially in the education, health, and road sectors.
It has improved on businesses, people are able to use them to access institutions and the health center, service centers like education. And in hospitals, health centers, and all that.
Under the Development Response to Displacement Impact Project, Kiriandongo has received 36 billion shillings since the inception of the program in 2018. The funding has so far supported 330 projects across the district.
So how many patients do you receive per day?
I have received 25 as OPD.
Okay. But now that you are alone, are you able to attend to them?
Yeah, we work on them because they come on each other.
Okay.
Report by Godfrey Muhumza for the news.